So what does it take to do this EOD task? First of all, you need well-trained personnel, you need the right equipment, you need the explosives, and then you are good to go. Regarding the well-trained personnel, let me state that the AFL personnel has been trained by the United Nations Mine Action Service, as well as by our Bangladesh engineers, and in the future they also will be trained outside country with specialist training. So they are well prepared and ready to take over this task.
How can AFL carry on this task? Because UNMIL is leaving, UNMIL is drawing down. And today we've been assured that our specialists, EOD specialists, can continue the job. And so again, we are grateful to the UNMIL family for first of all providing the capability and then giving us the necessary equipment to do the piece of job. I think Small Arms Commission will be glad to hear the news when it gets out there that indeed the AFL has both the technical capability and then the logistics to continue the job. I mean, that's a great achievement for the people of Liberia, Liberia as a whole.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, fire.
So, what we'd like to note is that the explosive ordnance disposal is a critical task of the security transition, right? It's really important. And since it directly impacts on the safety of Liberian people across the country, we have seen that over a number of years, unexploded ordnances have been identified. These things are a threat to civilians. They need to be dealt with. They need to be destroyed. And for a very long time, this has been done by the UNMIL engineers. You and units before you have done a really good job. But we've also seen that training has been ongoing, and we are now really at a good moment where this task is going to be taken over. We are, from the United Nations side, very happy to say that you now have the level of training, you now have the level of equipment after today, to continue with this task. And for that, we are really grateful that we could work together in a partnership to reach this point. I think it's important now to rather mark what is going to be made available. There is protective gear that will be made available for more than the teams that you have. So it should cover you for at least a short term. There is also, like the general has mentioned, explosive material that will be able to cover your requirements, projected requirements for the next 24 months, we are assuming. And we've also determined that what you require is commercially available off the shelf in Liberia today. So all of this is in your favor. We are also presenting you 4 vehicles that were purchased in the project so that you can respond quickly to these reports that the LMP will make to you for you to be able to respond to these occasions. We are looking forward now to coming to knock on your door for you to help us to destroy some of the things we have in the drawdown process. So I think the roles are reversed. If you allow me just one word of thanks and appreciation also to the UNMIL military, who is performed this function very well. We have had a number of engineering capabilities throughout the area, throughout the 13 years of our existence here, and you've all done a good job. So thank you very much.
The transition process have come a long way, and AFL by law being the force to support law enforcement. Long, even before today, we have worked with the UN to ensure that this critical task, which one of the member of the Liberian security sector was going to take the lead. We at the Ministry of National Defense, we cannot better re-emphasize that. This task, we have been trained to take over it, and today this occasion marks that turning over of the attacks and logistic tours. So, Your Excellency, on behalf of the Minister of Defense, I can assure you that with the training you have provided AFL and the logistic also you have provided, we will ensure that we, in collaboration with the LMP and the public, take over this task. So let me say thanks to the Bangladeshi who has been performing the task and also provided mentorship for AFL. We say job well done.